Welcome to our first Global Seed lesson. This video will introduce you to both of the school garden areas that we'll be using in all of our succeeding lessons in Starshine Academy and in Mission Montessori schools. But first, we'd like to give you an outline of how you can use our filmed lessons. You'll be provided with lesson plans, and you'll be provided with universally applicable sustainable system principles that can apply anywhere on the whole planet. The format for all of our hands-on lessons in Level 1 will be as follows. Each one will have an introduction of the topic, theory and demonstration, both of them by the teacher, implementation and practice by the students, then summary of principles by the teacher, and again, cleanup of materials by the students. Two schools will be featured in these lessons, as I mentioned, Starshine Academy, an inner-city K-12 program with a community garden, two impromptu outdoor classroom areas, and an outdoor garden and training class area. Mission Montessori, pre-6 program, will have an outdoor garden area and four well-equipped classrooms. Please note that an overview of the construction of Mission Montessori school garden will be shown, with each step to be taught later. It was built as a community garden, and I think you'll enjoy it. Now, this is how you use our Global Seed lessons. First, review the lesson principles listed in the DVD insert booklet, and next, observe the DVD lesson on how to teach the principles. Then review the lesson plan to identify how principles were broken down into teachable steps. Now, adjust your own lesson plans for the needs of your own class, age, ability, and budget. Lastly, return to the principles for student evaluation to make sure that all the principles were applied and understood by your students. You evaluate learning with authentic hands-on learning, testing, presentations, school community demonstrations, summarizing field trips, etc. You may get very creative, but make sure it's authentic. This same format will be used for all ensuing lessons, usually with theory being presented at Starshine Academy and then classroom practice being demonstrated at Mission Montessori schools. An important note to consider is that the best way to build a sense of community and responsibility for your older students is to have them always help and teach younger students, and also have your parents, grandparents, and community members help with their rich, rich experiences. So now our course introduction at the Inner City Starshine Academy. As we begin to explore Starshine Academy, please realize that it's an inner city school and has limited resources, as many of us do. Also, we are filming during an Arizona hot summer with temperatures well over 100 degrees, so you may hear the clicking of sprinklers in the background. Also, we want you to know that the students are taking turns filming, which I think is very amazing, and this is part of their whole education and responsibility. So as we said earlier, our lessons can have the appearance of home movies, which they are, but focus on the content and the value of the lessons, and you'll find that you'll find the films really very, very charming as we go along. My name is Dr. Heather Devich, and this is a course that we're doing on sustainability that's going to be empowering teachers to be able to help their students to do four very, very important things. They're going to help to empower their students to be able to produce their own organic food, to produce their own clean water, to produce their own renewable energy, and then ultimately to be able to produce their own green housing in the form of a classroom using alternative building materials like solar, adobe, brand earth, those types of things. The things that children are learning, there are four of them, four values for this whole training. One of the values is that, of course, it's going to be these very important skills that really have the potential for helping people one family at a time to relieve a lot of the environmental stress that our whole planet is having. Number two, it's going to be helping children to be able to feel a sense of what they're doing is so worthwhile, and there's tremendous character development that happens on three levels. Children learn about themselves, they learn about responsibility and self-esteem. They learn on another level, they learn about cooperation and how you interact in a responsible fashion in society. And then on another level, they really learn a sense of joy and a sense of love
of the beauty of all these surroundings that we have around us. And as they learn how our natural environment works, it really affects them. So there are just so many benefits that are going to be coming from this training. So we're going to start our, we're doing this at Starshine Academy, which is an inner city poverty school. This is a wonderful, wonderful school that has beautiful, wonderful, brilliant students in it who are really going to be making a difference in this world, one of whom is Angel, and Angel is our aide for the day. This is my high school student. She's in the 10th grade, and she has been helping with this whole school for at least a year. She's been working with all of the younger students with me. So we're going to start out with our pledge to the earth. I'm going to say the first statement, and then you can repeat it. You'll see here, by the way, I have some lovely Boy Scouts. I have Ramon, who's here. I have Claudia, his sister, who is here. I have another one of my wonderful student aides, Sienna, who's in fourth grade. And then I have Essence, who's also in fourth grade. And then I have Chinua, who's in second grade. And then I have wonderful teachers from Esperanza Montessori Academy and from Mission Montessori Academy. I have Miss Glenna. We have Miss Candace. And then we have the parent who has been organizing our whole parent teacher association, Miss Grace.
Yay!
All right. Now, our pledge. You repeat after me. I pledge allegiance to the earth.
I pledge allegiance to the earth.
And to all life that it nourishes.
And to all life that it nourishes.
All growing things.
All growing things.
All species of animals.
All species of animals.
And all races of people.
And all races of people.
I promise to protect all life on our planet.
I promise to protect all life on our planet.
To live in harmony with nature.
To live in harmony with nature.
And to share our resources justly.
And to share our resources justly.
So that all people can live with dignity.
So that all people can live with dignity.
In good health.
In good health.
And in peace.
And in peace.
Because a great component of what we're doing is if we start with the children, this is how we build peace on our planet. And also the child, the innocent, good child that's inside of every single one of us. Because partly what we're wanting to do is not only learn all these wonderful skills, we're really wanting these children of the future to be able to be citizens who know that, war is never a solution, that the only solutions are love. The environment where we're having the demonstrations. Today we're doing soil testing, composting. Over here we have the shelves that we have our materials on for all the classes that we're having. Here we have our area for cooling off our garden, our sprays, and for our pesticiding. Over here we have our area where we're doing scrubbing of our tools. Over here is our washing area where we wash off our gloves. Here we have the students' gloves, tools, and aprons. And over here we have water cans. On the other, okay, we'll look at the garden room. Now, Angel's going to continue on showing us this wonderful, miraculous garden. Now, I'm going to tell you, I came out here one Saturday with a bunch of Boy Scouts, and this was nothing. I'm telling you, nothing. And we set this whole garden up. The walkway came later, the next year. But this whole garden was from nothing. And I worked with two boys who were here with felonies. And those two boys turned their lives around. They came over on the weekends, and they kept this whole thing going for a year, totally by themselves. Come see what we have growing here. We've got zucchini here.
big. And we're going to do, come here, sweetheart. We're going to go over there in the shade in a second. We're going to do a lot of harvesting here. We've got tomatoes over here. You want to come over here, Sabella? So, Bella, look, we've got, what else do we have here?
Rose bushes.
This is the center of the garden. You want to get over here? This St. Francis. Because all of this whole school is built on a prayer for peace. The whole school is built on a prayer for the ecology and the goodness and the health of our whole planet. All right. Now, over here, look what we have grown over here. If you guys, let's get my Boy Scout over here. I need my two boys and Claudia. I want you guys to look really carefully without touching and see if you can see something growing in here.
Flowers?
He sees yellow flowers.
Oh, wow. I see it.
A squash.
You know what that is? That's a watermelon. Look over here, you guys.
Yum.
Can you see? Look, this is one of the biggest watermelons I think I've ever seen. It's this big. On Friday, we're gonna eat this. Can you see that, Miss Bella? Look at that.
Oh, yeah.
On Friday.
Oh,
yeah.
I see it.
Look at that. And then look, there's another one right over here. Can you see that one? Look.
Oh, I can see this one.
Neat. All right. Now, without stepping on our little, don't step on the sweet little, his little, sweet little toes. We're gonna come over here. We have figs growing right here.
Figs?
We've got figs that you can eat. Yep.
Figs. Oh, man, that's what I wasn't told to cook.
Look, we have apples. You guys want to walk over there. You can walk down this sidewalk, guys. Walk down this little brickway. Here we have citrus trees. We have
look at that basil.
Look, Bella, look. They just came out this year. Apples, isn't that amazing? Come on over here. We've got. Go ahead and walk over there, you guys, over to the shade.
Well, look at the little picture there. What does the little picture on the tree say?
You're going to get your butt wet?
That looks like grapefruit, maybe. Is it lemons?
It's something that begins with a dab. I'm going to be a green
pixie. Look at the grapes.
I have, well, you guys sitting on this lovely little bench. Here, sit down. I've got a story about this bench.
Oh, it's a story.
When we first, whenever we very first, isn't this a nice, cool place? Mm-hmm. There was nothing here. The very first day, whenever the two boys with the fellas came to help me to do this, we had a person who was here, a mother who was here, the Boy Scouts, and she said at the end of the day, she said, the garden's looking beautiful, but we've got to get rid of this yucky old bench.
Oh, no!
And then I just said very quietly, you know, my father built this bench for my mother, and I use this to bless every garden that we come to. And I said, this was a spool of baling wire from his old dairy down in South Phoenix. And she said, I'm sorry, I didn't realize it's beautiful. And the principal immediately said to those two felon guys, she said, I want you never to forget what happened here. Because Miss Heather told the story of this bench, it takes on a life of its own. And she said, it's the same as you.
Right.
People can, like, throw you away and say you're not important, and that's absolutely untrue. That God does not create junk, that every single human being is here to be doing something that's really important. You tell your story, and you transform your life into something beautiful and growing, just like this garden.
That's
why we're keeping this grubby old, really, really grubby old bench.
Rustic.
It's rustic, all right.
And there's a couple, and there's some bird poop.
There is some bird poop on it. You're right, sweetheart.
Now we've got
grapes over here.
Oh, boy.
We also have, like, some raisins
growing here. Hey, are they
you
ready?
You have to take them off the vine to have them turn into raisins?
We're gonna be baking raisins later on. Later on this weekend.
It's so cute!
Try a grape. Okay, sweetheart. Now, we hope that they're ripe. We don't know yet. No, it's delicious. Taste it. It's sweet.
It's amazing. Look at it.
So, And then over there we have some kumquats, and we have some mangoes growing. So this really is a place.
Oh, where's the mangoes?
And that's what we're learning about, is how gardens really grow our spirits, grow our souls, and how we're going to be helping our whole earth. Okay, so shall we go over and let's get started now?
Right. Cook on Thursday. We're gonna come over. We're gonna harvest.
Yes, you want to get squirted? Does somebody want to get squirted?
No.
It helps.
I've got my
Ramon head. Wants to be squirted.
Yeah. All right. Here we go. Woo!
That
it
can be used and walked on now by hundreds, if not thousands, of people by the example that she's giving and leading this school forward.
Right here, what we had a big program last year, right?
Yeah.
The United Nations sent over their peace conference to this school last year. No place else in the whole world. 9/11. And so tell us about the peace pole, honey.
They donated this in our school. They put it in our school to recognize peace. And it says, may peace prevail on earth.
May peace prevail on earth. Right. In all different languages. Japanese, Hindi, English.
And he probably knows.
Arabic.
And Spanish.
Spanish.
All around.
All around. And the Rotary Club donated this as like a symbol of peace and unity for all humanity from the United Nations Conference.
And then inside, every
student has for you three.
Like a letter to themselves. In the next 2 years, and
did you hear that, Miss Bella? There was a time capsule, so that every student in this school put in. What did they put it
like
into?
Like a picture or a letter or what they want to do in life.
Right.
Put it in.
Right.
There.
A prayer and a hope for the future, and they buried it in this time capsule. Now let's move from Starshine Academy over to Mission Montessori for an all-day garden raising experience with the whole community. We'll consolidate this into a few minutes, and it's going to be a little fast, and I hope that you'll be patient with some of the jerky-looking photography, because this was a very complex technological thing for the kids to figure out how we're going to be doing it. But I still think you'll be able to see the lovely progression of going from absolutely nothing, an empty space, into a wonderful, wonderful garden at the end of the afternoon. Here's that empty, filled-in swimming pool area. And everybody's assembling all the tools that we're going to need. The kids are getting ready to work. They're putting on their aprons and gloves. And something that I think is so amazing is that they just spontaneously help each other. That's kind of like what gardening does to we human beings. It just civilizes us. Now they're removing weeds. They think it's a wonderful thing to do, and they're getting their tools and digging them up, putting them in the bucket, and they'll use them for compost later. The heat of the compost will kill any seeds that might be there from the weeds. Now all the parents are gathering to help us. We're putting together our tools, and later on we're going to have safety lessons with all the children for how they use tools. The real lessons do start with the next video, but this one, of course, you have to have a garden before you can start giving the lessons. So here the kids are washing all their tools, and they're just loving it in their prepared environment with all the garden materials that they're going to need being assembled on lovely, logical shelves. So now the parents are coming, and we're figuring out where we're going to put an arch. We have dads and grandpas and potted flowering vines, and we'll put the arch right in the middle of the swimming pool area. Make sure it's in the right spot. And now we'll bring some lovely, lovely potted vines. Now these blue flowers will grow up over the whole top of this arch and make it a lovely space for the center of our garden. Now the kids are putting together the boards
for the beds. We're going to make raised garden beds. You can do this any number of ways. You can put the beds into the ground, or you can make them just on the top of the ground. But look at these kiddos. Look at them. My goodness. They're just carrying everything, and they're so intent on helping us to make sure we have all the garden, all the beds spaced correctly for the garden. So we decide we're going to have 8 beds, 8 feet by 2 feet, so the children can really reach them. Now, biointensive gardening is fabulous with the raised beds because you get 4 times the yield. You use only 1/4 of the water. You have natural pest control. You have no weeding problems, and we're also going to be having a whole composting system that you use for making the soil. We'll show that later on. Now, the sides can be staked if you have narrow boards, which are inexpensive, or you can nail them. But the kids need to be able to help because you have to do it according to whatever budget that you have. So figure out what's best for your school. You can use stones to put it in the ground. You can use bricks around it. You can use all kinds of borders. Just get creative. But this is really the fastest, easiest way to do it. To use loose the soil underneath, and then you have 2 feet of usable soil. So look at this little kiddo here. The kids are very seriously helping out with this. And again, I'm asking you to realize that this was a whole day that these kids worked so diligently. Look at all that hammering. We have college students helping us. Safety goggles are optional, but they're lots of fun. The kids just love to put on uniforms. So concentration and coordination are vital for education, and they really are the natural outcomes of all this hands-on learning. Look at the focus of those kids. All that orderly behavior. Order and independence, vital for life skills, are also a natural outcome of all the hands-on learning. So kids, teens, everyone works together. So now we're eyeballing the beds and trying to decide what's the best placement for them. And so the dads are beginning doing the hammering, and then the kids are going to be doing it. Look at that. Self-esteem and concentration are vital for happiness, and they're also natural outcomes of hands-on learning. All these skills give the children such a sense of independence and such a sense of, I can do anything. I can help feed my family. So now you can see in a relatively short time, all of these 8 beds are taking place. The kids love their little uniforms, by the way. This is in case somebody was sneezing from the dust, but it's more that it's fun because the kids just love the gear and clothing that signify the role that they're fulfilling in the adult with their adult skills. But it's real work that they're doing. I mean, they're hammering, they're doing everything else that everyone else is doing. Arizona State University, the Sun Devils. So here's Jodine Tryon. She's the Mission Montessori, the owner and the executive director of this whole wonderful program. And so she's bringing some new, outdoor equipment for us to be using. So the children, you can see, they can use carefully many adult implements when they have demonstration and supervision. And they're very, very careful with what they do. If you trust them, they're going to be living up to your trust. You just make sure they have the kind of training that it is that they really need and the kinds of tools that are appropriate for their hand size. Because hand-eye coordination is really the tool of human civilization. So now we're getting close to being done with all these beds. We've got all 8 of them pretty much where we need to have them, in the middle of our garden. And you'll see what we'll do with the rest of this empty-looking space in a few minutes. I love this little kiddo. Notice his focus and his persistence, his determination, and the obvious joy with all the work, young and old, everybody. This was a joyful, joyful experience. Aha, here comes our roller grass. So we're going to roll it out and piece it all together. Now, we've watered the area earlier, so the ground is really prepared. And so we can have good, solid contact with moist soil from which we remove the rocks And you have little holes that help penetration so that the water goes down and roots can go down also. And it's great that this one area is now going to instantly be covered with grass. Isn't that great? Look at the kids. Those rolls are really heavy, but the kids are just in there just doing it. Thank goodness we got the dad with all the muscles, huh? Okay, now we're rolling it all out, and the kids are taking really special, look at the jumping. That special, I love John Justin jumping, that special attention he's doing to making good contact with the ground. And notice he's jumping right along the seams, because the seams do need really a lot of extra mashing, so they all go together. Okay, so that's, you can use a big expensive roller for this, but we're trying to do it in a way that's relatively inexpensive for everybody. We're doing it by foot. Then after we have everything pieced and placed, then we're going to water thoroughly. And here we are leveling and removing more rocks and debris down from the end there, which the kids love to do. All of these tasks they just think are so fabulous. And it doesn't matter the age. The old kids, the young kids, everybody. They just jump in and do it. Okay, so here we are adding a little more dirt to make our grass level. Because it does need to be level so that you don't have pockets that have too much water and places that have no water. Otherwise, your grass won't grow evenly. Here again, Mom's giving special attentions to the seams, mashing everything down. And then here we go with raking it up so we can water it where it's been mashed up from being rolled. So now in the areas or in the corners, we're cutting it and piecing it. And the kids just think that's a fun, wonderful thing to do. It's like doing a puzzle. So we're putting in little chunks to fill everything in, and now John Justin is starting to do the watering for us. Oh, and look at the furniture. We have kid-sized furniture that we have because the school, of course, goes up to sixth grade, and oh, and there's Essence spraying for us, and there's Chinua getting everything ready. And so now we have our finishing touches. We have a lovely little fountain. We have a little fence that will keep the younger children, when they come in the morning, from stomping all of the grass that's trying to grow. So we're just pressing that in. Oh, and look, we have a nice little bench the kids can sit on. And now we have a sundial. Okay, good. Now we have a little angel with our own angel bench. That angel is a bird feeder. The kids can put seeds in her lap. So now Miss Bella, our videographer, is taking some films because doesn't it look so different than it did a few minutes ago? Just a blank old swimming pool area, nothing. Now we'll bring in some lovely potted plants that the kids themselves have decided what flowers are in what pots. Aha, we did good. It's starting to look lovely. Very, very charming. Let's put in our welcome sign. So, oh yeah, Essence thinks she needs to get all those films. Now, we're going to start filling the beds with compost. Now, we did loosen the soil underneath with a big old digging fork. That's called double digging. And we did loosen that up so that we have the soil loose for 1 foot underneath all of these beds. You'll get a good lesson on that in a while. So now we're trying. Do we need scissors to open up these compost bags? You know, since we're doing a brand new garden, that's why we're doing commercial compost. You don't need to do commercial compost. You can amend your own soil, but it takes longer. And then we'll keep this soil amended later on with our very own compost from our garden, that compost that we're making ourselves. That's a fabulous lesson. You're going to love it. Because if you don't have good compost, compost is just like food for us. The soil must have rich, rich compost so it gets all the minerals and vitamins and all the nutrients that it needs to grow. So now we're making sure that the sides are straight after we filled in our beds, because that does put pressure on the sides of the beds. Okay, now look at all the kids raking, hand shovels, just really getting it all smooth. But one thing, there's John Justin standing on our soil. You never, never, never stand on your soil, because then it compacts the soil, and then your roots can't penetrate into the soil anymore. So now we've got to loosen that back up, and there he goes. So, you know, we've been here all morning, and now it's lunchtime. So now the kids, we just said it was time to eat. The kids said, nope, we're working. That's how gardening affects all the children. They're working. So now we're softening back up all that soil and getting everything even, getting ready to do our planting pretty soon. Ah, look at that. It's just looking like a real garden, isn't it? I think that we put, you can put like about 4 bags of compost, depending on the size, in each one of these, in each one of your garden beds. But you can adjust that according to how you make your beds. Finally, the kids are eating lunch. But I think it's hilarious. They insisted that we have a working lunch. They went about to quit working, so you'll see us pretty soon chomping food while we're still working. So now, it's a little bit later, right after lunch. Some of the parents are coming, and we've got a different group of kids coming in. Sorry for stuffing the cookie in my mouth there. Even the babies are here. Everybody's enjoying how beautiful it is. Building a garden is such a wonderful, wonderful community happening. Now we're putting outdoor furniture because our classrooms are going to be lovely. We're putting out some lovely little umbrellas. It's going to be shady and so beautiful. Everyone will be amazed when they come into school on Monday, and they're going to see everything just transformed. So now the next step is we're going to put out these lovely stepping stones, inexpensive little terracotta ones, so that you don't step on the grass. You only step on the stones. We have various kinds of potted plants. Of course, we'll do our sprouting of our own plants later on, but just so we're starting out correctly, we're putting in bulbs, we're putting in seeds, and we're putting in sprouted plants and companion planting of lovely flowers. We have some self-pesticiding plants you'll see pretty soon. So now, John Justin with his purposeful activity. You have to have a prepared environment that allows the child to make their own choices, which they can carry out independently with no one telling them what to do. They have the materials that they need, and then they'll just focus and they'll do whatever is necessary, and they'll put everything away when they're all done. That's the purpose of a prepared environment. Now the kids are starting planting our bulbs. Okay. So these are some, we'll talk about our self-pesticiding plants in a while. These are companion plants that we're putting in here. And the kids are being so careful, making a little well around the plants so the water has a good place to be. We're also going to be, we put water in first, and then you put in the plants, and you make sure the roots are well covered up. Otherwise your plant won't grow correctly. There we go. All right, he's got it in there. We are just about done with that bed. So these very useful plants, which we can continue to be eating, the garlic and the onions, on a continual basis, you just nip it off the top, need watering. And now we're putting in some herbs for our little herb bed. We've got chives, we have parsley, we have basil, oregano, all kinds of wonderful herbs. And it's the same thing with the herbs. You just take a part of it and the plant just keeps on growing. So look at that. Here we are finished. We have our stones all laid out. We're putting in our scarecrow so we don't have any of our birds coming. This is Harry the Scarecrow. You'll meet him in a while. And all the kids now are saying bye, and look at that. Whoa, so proud of their garden. Oops, stand up, Harry. And so now we're saying bye to everybody, and boy, did they do good work. Harry says bye, everybody says bye. And they're just so excited about what's going to happen in the morning when the other kids come and see
They'll be so amazed. They're going to say, what happened to that ugly piece of dirt right there in our school? Oh, Chinua is thrilled with himself. He feels the love of our garden. He feels the love that happens with work, the love that feels with, that happens with cooperating between parent and child, grandparent and grandchild. Gardens really feed your soul, not just your body. So now we put some lovely little figures and things. There's the bird seed I told you about with our angel. There we potted some more of our plants, and whoa, we are now finished. We are finished, and we did good. Yes, we did a great job. Bye-bye, everybody. Bye-bye. Yeah. Thank you, Chinua. We love you.